Okay, so after that run, we're going to have Kirby and the Amazing Dream Mirror coming up right now by Kinnan. So let's not wait any longer and switch to it.
Yes. It's amazing.
You are live.
Okay, so hello everyone. I'm Ken 11. This is Kirby and Amazing Mirror. He's standing there to hard reset because when the cutscene plays, for some reason the game will lag a lot during play. So we hard reset it to fix that. So you can hard reset now. We only have to do it. It's a bit annoying, but we can deal with it. So yeah. I'm just gonna start off. I'm gonna erase a file. Okay. In 3, 2, 1, go. Oh no! Okay, so in Kirby and Amazing Mirror, you basically have the same mechanics as in Kirby Nightmare and Dreamland. If anyone's ever played that. We're gonna do a little trick here, and I failed it. This is harder than it looks, and I filled it twice, and now the other Kirby's are there. So you can actually skip having to wait for the Kirby's there, but I'm bad, so I didn't get it. It's a lot more finicky than it looks sometimes. And we're gonna perform a mix here. And we filled it. So it isn't a Kirby game without mixes. Filled it again. This is a pretty annoying mix to do. Not sleep. Can tell you that much. I'm trying to get wheel. I'll try it one more time and then I'll just continue without wheel. Got it. So apparently, I learned today that it's a two-frame trick to get that, and it's a bit of annoying timing. So wheel is blatantly overpowered in this game, because the game has these really long levels. So you'll be seeing wheel a lot this game. A little bit about the story of the game. So at the start, the game tells you, like, there's trouble in a land above Dreamland, and it's called the Mirror World, or something like that. And so our trusty hero, Meta Knight, goes and investigates it. But for some reason, that creates a dark Meta Knight that splits Kirby into four other Kirbys. You can see them in the top left of your screen. And stuff goes wrong, basically. So you go into the Mirror World, and there you see Meta Knight fighting Dark Meta Knight, and he crushes the Amazing Mirror, which basically into 8 pieces. That was it. That was a little. And sorry, movements. And so you have to find all 8 pieces back and defeat the final boss at the end. That's basically, that's all you need to know about the story. So, what I just skipped there was a button. What that button does is create a door in the home room, which I entered a moment ago. These doors are useful, because they provide quick access through the rest of the game. This is sort of like a Metroidvania game. In the way that it... Oh my god, movements. Okay. I shouldn't talk and do movement at the same time. There's a sort of Metroidvania game, as in it's a giant maze with a lot of chests and stuff like that. And to get certain chests, you need to complete puzzles. Luckily, this is any percent, so we only have to grab all 8 shards, and then we're done. So I'm gonna press this button here, because this connection is the most important door to open, because it gives me easy access to wheel, which, well, is pretty strong. So here we have our first boss. He's called King Golem, which is basically a replacement for Wispy Woods. And that was King Golem. Stone is pretty good against enemies, so that's nice. At the end of every boss fight, except one, we soft reset, because it's slightly slower, because we go back to the home room anyways, like right here. And then we're gonna go over here and grab wheel. Hmm? Did it say slightly slower?
Yes.
Oh. Oops. Yeah, it's slightly faster to actually soft reset there. Okay. So I'll be focusing on movement a lot throughout. I don't really have much to tell when I'm doing wheel movements. There's one thing I haven't explained yet, and that is wheel jumping. You might have noticed that sometimes when I start a wheel, I gain a lot of height randomly with jumping, like this. That is called a wheel jump, and it's actually not completely intended that you gain that much height. I'm messing up a lot of movement. It's actually even crazier than in Kirby's Squeak Squad. In this game, you like traverse half the screen. In Squeak Squad, you traverse the entire screen, which is really crazy. So we go down here to another area. There are 9 main areas in this game. And 8 of those areas have a boss. I should have gone save threats there instead of those threats. Oh well. So whenever you get hit in this game, you will instantly lose your ability, which is... Or like, it'll drop in that star and you can re-grab it, but... I'm not always on top of that. So sometimes it just disappears. So... It is actually faster to, instead of like, continuing on, just go back here and grab wheel again, and then go back to the area I was, right here. Now we're gonna go into Radish Ruins, which is a beautiful place, as you can see. So most of the start is sort of like set up to get certain doors that we need to find the other areas of the game with. And we basically, we've got the doors we need for like the next 3 bosses or something like that. You might also notice that I'm trying to avoid hitting enemies, because every time you hit an enemy, you will gain a few lag frames. So it'll slow you down a bit, which we don't want. Holy shit, that was way more lag than I expected. Where's this lag coming from? Probably, but I'm not used to it. So, yeah. This game has a mode where you can play with 4 different players. It's really bad because it lags the game a giant amount because it's constantly trying to synchronize. Yeah. They did a 4. Yeah, I'm not sure if they heard that, but they did a 4-player run at HDQ, and it was slower than world record. It's just really bad when it comes to lag. They're actually going to do a 2-player co-op any percent of this at next SGDQ. Pretty excited for that. We got some good guys working on the route and stuff like that. So you saw me kill that bomb enemy there. That is to avoid the second crash from happening, which is pretty nice. Small time save. And then the area becomes... a lot more daunting, or at least more dramatic. I'm actually gonna grab some health here. I usually don't, but a little bit of marathon safety. So we grab sword here to fight. Question mark, question mark, question mark. It's probably the rival from Pokemon. So, Meta Knight is kind of annoying. He can block your attacks like that, and then you don't deal any damage to him. But that was a pretty decent fight still. And that is shard number two. I should have called this game Kirby GBA and the Mirror Shards. So we soft reset, and then we're going to go back to the left here, into this door, grab stone, and continue on to another area. So we just beat the boss of Radish Ruins, but we still haven't beaten the boss from... from Cabbage Cavern, so we're gonna do that now. And we grab stone mostly to be able to enter this area here. Otherwise we wouldn't be able to get here. And we can fight walkers with it quite quickly. We drop stone and we grab throw here. So what throw does is you can suck up enemies or items, and you can throw them up at people. Pretty basic. You even have these nice stars when you're sucking. And now we have Moly. Moly is a bit of a troll. It's completely RNG if he does the right thing, and he's doing the wrong things right now. I like to have him do this. Nice. Okay, I probably messed up. There we go. And that was Moly. You can actually, if you get lucky, you can one-cycle him, but I got really, really unlucky. So that's kind of annoying. And then we soft-reset at the end. I'm trying not to soft-reset too early, because if I do that, the game doesn't actually save me getting the shard. So I have to wait like about a second every soft-reset, else I will basically have to do the entire segment again. So now we're gonna go back here, and instead of going down, we're gonna go left. To another area. I usually get hit by the Waddledoo, so I'm not gonna be annoyed by it. Oh wow! That is way harder than it looks, dodging that weird bomb guy. I usually don't go for it, but I just randomly did it without even trying, so that's pretty cool. It is ridiculously hard to do that, in my opinion. Now we're gonna float up here, across all these Gordos. So a lot of the rooms here kind of feel like filler to me whenever I play this game. But there are some pretty cool rooms here and there. And chat goes wild. Okay. So we pressed a few buttons that are set up for later. And we're gonna go back to the left here. Into Carrot Castle. You might notice that every single area, except one, has to do with food. And alliterates. So you saw me drop wheel there and quickly keep it in my mouth. It lasts about 1.8 seconds when I do this perfectly, which I just did, so that's kind of annoying. But you basically make sure that when you miss, you won't lose your ability, which is useful. And then we got a little bit of a break, finally. Nobody touch my beard, please. So this is Mega Titan, and I can never get the double hit on there, and I messed up. So you want to push him to the electric things. That's the only thing that can... Oh, Oh my god, I didn't lose Bill. That's the only thing that can hurt him in this form. And I keep messing stuff up. I'm actually really annoyed when I do that. And after he killed the Mega Titan, the Titan head comes out. And that can actually get hurt. That, and then we get the shard. So this is the only moment in the run where I won't soft reset after getting the boss. That is simply because I already have wheel, so that's nice. And another bonus is the next area I need to go to is the same area as I entered first in this segment, which is here. So that's pretty useful. So that saves a little bit of time. And then we go down here this time. So you might notice that whenever I'm at the edge of a ledge, I will slide off. Whenever you do that, a bit of your speed gets saved. Or like you keep going for a little bit, so you have some momentum. And that speeds you up a little bit, which is nice. So this is all of Ocean, which is a pretty nice area. You can actually get stuck here a little bit, because there's a door coming up, which is a door to nowhere, basically, that doesn't give you the button. This door. You have to actually go past it, and then you have this door, which you have to enter the button. A lot of this game is set up like a giant maze, so it's... A lot of people get lost when they first play this game, but if you ever play this game for the first time, I recommend to you find all the maps and read the fucking maps. I know some people who didn't do that when they first played the game and got lost a lot. So this is Boxy. Boxy is annoying when he goes into the corner. But if he's a little bit out of the corner, he can just... So coming up is another mix, and the setup is annoying, but I got it, and it is for UFO. So what we used to do here is grab a sword a little later, and use that to skip a certain area, but we don't have to because now we use this mix for UFO, which is really cool. Overkill that poor Blipper. So, you have to go all the way around here, but with UFO you can just skip all that. Just go like that, which is pretty nice. So, a small thing about swimming in this game. You can only swim down when you're not going left or right, which is somewhat annoying. But it's something you deal with, that's annoying. So you basically see me like press the A button to go up every now and then. Or just hold it. I can also mash it and get the sound a lot. Ah damn, that was a little early on the damage boost. So we damage boost to get through that Gordo. You can do a little bit, you can do it a little bit faster because when you get hit you bounce up from those guys, spikes, which is pretty nice. Use burning here to go through the section nice fast. I like to get hit on those spikes to get into the cannon instantly without having to press any buttons because I'm lazy like that. Here we switch to stone. We only really have a bunch of swimming sections coming up, and there's no ability that speed up swimming sections. So it's best to just grab stone here. We also need it for the next boss anyways. Stone is a really good boss killer in this game. And here we are in the area of the next boss. Dang. Unlucky. There we go. And that was Gobbler. Yeah. I think so, yeah. Three more. But probably some of the most annoying ones are coming up next. First one of the annoying ones is Wiz. So we go here. And there's actually another spot where we can grab wheels somewhat quickly. And that's back here. Probably seen this area a little bit. And the only reason why it's faster is because we have to go here anyways, so it's just easier to grab a wheel there rather than to grab it somewhere else. Now we're in Peppermint Palace, which is probably one of the cuter themes. And we press the buttons. So technically, I can go all the way to the left here instantly, but I want to press both the buttons because for the last segment, I need to go here a little later. Dang, that was horrible. I'm trying to jump over as many enemies as I can, but I'm really messing it up. Trying to go fast so I can skip getting hit by a flamer. Nice! That twister tends to hit me, so it's always nice when I do not get hurt by it. So there's a mix here you can do with that Sword Knight and the Sparky, but the setup is like frame perfect, so I don't go for it. And the mix itself is also pretty stupid. And you mix for a hammer, but Parasol is just as fast. Well, it's slightly slower, but it's more swag because you have a freaking Parasol. So this is Wiz. Wiz is a troll. Like that. He likes to run into you and summon enemies you can't do stuff against. That was a pretty decent Wiz. I got lost my ability a few times, but that's fine. Wiz can be a really big troll. Oh, that was a little late on the reset. Now we're gonna go back here. And we're gonna go, instead of grabbing wheel, we're gonna go to right here. You could actually do this entire section with missile, but missile is really hard to control, as you will see later on. I completely suck at it. I haven't taken the time into actually learning how to do it properly. So instead we grab burning here, so we can go through these blocks. So I'm walking here so to not disturb that mirror. That enemy, when you run towards it, it will dive into the ground and you have to reload the entire area before you can go through that door, which is really annoying. So you try and walk before doing anything. Now we're gonna go all the way up here. Did I say this game has really large rooms? Yeah. I'll say it again. Actually, I'd like to keep burning here for a little bit. Doesn't save that much time, but it makes stuff a little easier if I don't mess up. And that's all we need from burning. Because here we have wheel. This game has been nicknamed Kirby and the Amazing Wheel. I have no idea why. It's just stupid. Okay, nice. Nice, we got lucky. So that Shadow Kirby gives you certain items, and if you get lucky you get invincibility candy. So you can just hover into this enemy and it'll die quickly. But that was the easy part, because now we have a boss, and we grab stone there. I completely suck at this boss. It's Krakow! Oh my god. Yeah, I sometimes make the worst decisions when fighting this boss. And sometimes it just goes really fast. And I just end him quickly. That was just horrible. I still haven't figured out how to do that boss on certain patterns. Stop clapping. So not a final shard. We grab wheel again because wheel's nice. Oh god. So this is why we pressed those buttons earlier. So we can quickly go here. And the only reason, like, we have already beaten the boss from. Oh damn, that's just not good at all. No, I don't want those two. So the ground here has ice physics, and everyone loves ice physics when speedrunning, don't they? They're the absolute best. Because the wheel is awesome. Yes. And it's got James. Water physics in Kirby games are usually decent. Yeah, that's the only problem. So I'm getting mediocre RNG on this Flosty. A fun thing about this game is that the enemy I just beat is called Frosty, but for some reason the English translation calls him Flosty. Apparently food is here, which is really annoying. Because I'm hungry. No, everyone's leaving me! So here we are in Candy Constellation. There's actually a loop I just escaped. There's a loop there. And if you go a certain direction and go up there, you will escape the loop. So this section is really annoying. I tend to lose wheel on a regular basis here. So I'm gonna focus a little bit on doing stuff right. And that is not doing stuff right. There we go. Okay. This next area is pretty easy. Just wheel through. And then we get into the lag room, and you will soon see why we call this the lag room. It's not here yet. Soon we'll start getting laggy. Nice. Well, we got lucky and didn't get that much lag, but here at the end we'll probably see a bunch. Lag. And then we get to Monster Hand. Did I mention this game was made after Super Smash Bros. Melee? It's actually pretty funny because in the German translation of this game, when you get the smash ability, it's actually called SSBM, which is pretty funny. So when I beat the Master Hand there, you saw the screen not catch up in time. The wheel actually goes so fast that screen transitions can't keep up with it. That's just how fast wheel is. Actually really happy that I kept wheel. So there's a route up here, but I haven't practiced it, and it's really annoying because you have to jump at the right moments. And I can't do that, so I'll just run into every single enemy. Yes, there's water in midair. Don't question it, it's a Kirby game. It happens often. So this is missile. Missile is really annoying to control. So you can missile through this entire room, but I can't, so I don't do it. It feels really slow to me when I use a missile to steer. So now I look to what my other Kirbys have, and they have not really good abilities, so I'm not gonna call them. If they have good abilities, I will call them in this fight with Master Hand and Crazy Hand. So Master Hand has the most health, so we kill him first for some reason. And then we kill Master Hand, Crazy Hand second. And that is the final piece of our beautiful mirror. So it's all nice and yellow again, and shiny. Mostly shiny. And we soft reset. So now we go into the mirror, and then instantly soft reset. That is to set a flag for the game, to think that we've already seen the cutscene that plays. And now we grab stone, we call our friends, because we don't want our fans to be there during the fight, because they'll cause a lot of lag. And we can just skip the cutscene, because we've quote-unquote already seen it. So this is Dark Meta Knight. He is a little bit more powerful than normal Meta Knight. And a lot more annoying as well. Oh my god. But with a bunch of perseverance you can kill him easily. And now I'm floating in midair. I'm not sure if this saves any time, but it looks cool, so I just do it every time. So, Meta Knight throws his sword after you, which is called Master. And we suck it up with another ability to create a double star. And I'm getting unlucky here. And we use it like this. So the star, double star actually, when it first hits, Dark Mind will flinch backwards. Making it so that the double star hits again. So we basically get two hits that deal half his health and just insta-kill him, making these fights pretty easy. He always has two mirrors. I'm trying to grab abilities as quickly as I can. Saves a little bit of time over grabbing them in these areas. And in the on the next fight, I really, really want one, because that'll save me 10 seconds. But chances are I'm not gonna get lucky for that. Yeah, he spinned his mirror, so I'm not lucky enough for it. So if I got either fire or ice, I would have been able to skip having to do all this and just go to the final boss instantly, but sadly we didn't get lucky. And we have to grab sword here. Nope. So this Dark Mind... damn it, is a little bit more annoying. I messed up. Because there's ice on the ground, so there's ice physics all the time. And he has a little bit more health than the other ones. So we'll just get Crash real quick here. Get a double star. And now we're gonna try a mix. If we get lucky. Because this part is all RNG now. If we can get the mix. I'm looking to try and suck up green stars. And there, he just shot two in the wrong direction. No green stars. I'll wait for a little bit longer and then I'll just continue without it. Too early, god damn it. So I'm looking for UFO here. I'll try it one more time if I can get lucky. This part is kind of, yeah, annoying. No green stars. Wow! Oh my god, I hate myself. fire. Okay, I'm just gonna go without. Wait, I didn't actually hurt him enough. That's really bad. I didn't notice that. No, we're not. Don't worry. I'll tell you when we're getting close on time. We're not even close to time. Especially. There we go. Damn it. Especially if I have to hit him a bunch of times still. I didn't notice that I didn't deal enough damage to him. There we go. So this is the fifth phase of Dark Mind. I'm gonna call my friends real quick because they give you health. Like that. They just kiss you and give you health. They're nice people like that. And this is Dark Mind 5. So with UFO, I'm trying to hit him and the mirror at the same time. Or just his mirror. His mirror, if you hit the mirrors, you get more damage. Oh my god, he keeps closing his eyes the moment I try to hit him. When his eyes close, you can't hurt him. And he does this, for instance. Flips the screen. But we beat him, so that's pretty nice. So the next phase of Dark Mind is the last phase, so if someone could be ready on time. This run is horrible, but whatever. It's not that difficult to find. Lilith can help you. So, as every Kirby needs, there's just one thing we need. A shmup. So I'm basically mashing a button as quickly as I can and trying to hit Dark Mind. And Dark Mind is a bit of a bitch. He keeps moving around. I don't like that when he does that. Stop moving. And ready on time. Time! Oh! So, a fun thing about the credits. You can still shoot him during it, and you have this little counter in the bottom right.